understand, let me be clear as I close. I'm not telling you not to pray. Don't misunderstand that. I'm not telling you not to pray. I'm telling you you should pray. But your prayer life is out of your relationship with God. Now let me say something else real quick. I'm done. Your prayer life is not about you giving God a laundry list of stuff you need him to do.
Amen.
That's what we do.
Yes.
We go to prayer, and before we even listen to God about anything, we just start talking. God, my sister needs, my brother needs, I need God. And then when you get done telling what you want, you say amen. And you get up and you walk away. That's the way I used to teach this. Listen, I used to teach this, brother. I used to teach and tell people, when you get done praying, stay down there a while and listen to what God has to say. That's what I used to teach. But I don't teach that anymore. You know what I teach now? There's nobody wants to have a conversation where you occupy the whole conversation the entire time. And I gotta wait until you get done with everything you want to pour out. And then I finally get a chance to say something.
Yeah.
And I catch you?
Yeah. Come on.
That's your husband, right? That's your husband. You do not want. You don't want her to sit there and talk to you for an hour straight. And then nowhere in the conversation does she let you say anything. Do you? But for a whole hour, she's just talking, and you never get to get a word in. By the time you get to the end of the conversation, all the stuff you want to say in the beginning, you can't even say because you forgot it. Am I right? Well, this is the difference in what I teach now. I don't tell people to wait down the end of the conversation with God and then listen to see what he said. I tell them, now, when you start talking to him, pause while you're praying and listen. Pause in between time. Give him some space to speak. Hello?
Amen.
Give God some space to talk to you. Yes. Conversation is dialogue. Yes. Not monologue. Mono, one person talking.
Yes.
That's not what this is. That's not what prayer is. Prayer is dialogue. I'm helping somebody right here. Prayer is dialogue. You got to let God talk. Most of us have been guilty, haven't we? I came here tonight to challenge that in you. Because if you develop in your prayer life and learn what it means to allow God the opportunity to talk to you, it'll change your life forever. I'm not talking about when you're going down the road and you just suddenly hear him. I'm talking about in your prayer time. Paul, let him speak. He will. Y'all believe that? He will talk to you. Sometimes it's going to be silent, sometimes it's going to talk. But you got to just be open and give him space to talk. Let him deal with your heart. Because it's in that place when you get answers, then you know how to handle the stuff that comes against you. And then you start talking with the authority that he delegated to you. And you start answering stuff that's been against you with, no, you can't stand against me. I know who I am. I know who I am. I know who I am. They don't have to run up and pray for me if I come to the altar anymore. I'm coming to have to deal with God. I'm coming, when I come up here, I'm coming to deal with God for myself. I don't care if praise and worship is going on, I'm running up here to pray and pray. I'm not necessarily needing somebody to run up and lay hands on me because I got this. I know where to get my strength from.
God, amen.
Amen.
Thank you for wanting to pray for me, but sometimes I just need it to be me and God.
That's right.
Amen.
Let me and God handle this. I promise you, if I can stay here long enough, just give me a minute at the altar. Let me stay here just a few minutes. I promise you. I thank you, brothers and sisters, for agreeing with me. But listen, I got enough power and relationship with God. Let me stay here just a little bit longer. I promise you, by the time I walk away from this altar,